Okay, so today we're working on spearing heaven and earth and reaching into the structure versus sort of trying to arm wrestle the other person's punch or grab out of the way. So if Mike punches with his right arm, left arm, flip a coin, right? So instead of like blocking and trying to muscle the arm out of the way, in Bagua, what we end up doing, entering with Wild Goosley's flock into dragon, here in spearing heaven and earth, the lead hand enters, and we can, you know, this is perfect for being in a crouch in a defensive position and then going up. And the trick is when you drop your elbow in, drop your, and open your scapula and push it into your elbow, and that gives you access to the other person's face, neck. The second hand starts off almost as if you're going to be in Green Dragon Stretch's claws, right? So you're not going to be in this, hey, I got this perfect kung fu, you know, posture, hold on a second. You know, you're going to be from a stance that's, you know, natural, ready, on the street. Punch comes in, you throw your arms up, you expand into the other person's structure, and when you step, right, when you step and press that second hand and make contact before you sit, you're pushing across and down. So normally with Green Dragon Stretch's claws, if Mike punches, right, you're here and you come in and you just slam the other person around with Green Dragon Stretch's claws. Here you're going for a combination of a slam, and the initial slam, but also when you step through and make contact, you're going to be drilling your hand down. You're reaching down and doing a palm strike that reaches across and down as you are spiraling the structure of your forearm. So you are amplifying the kinetic energy that is coming across and down. On, and if you have your stepping pattern, your mud stepping instincts on, you'll end up kicking the foot, kicking the ankle, right? So here, you know, I'm stopping myself from kicking his ankle, but if I was gonna step through and actually pretend I'd actually done that, right? And then came through with that, there's even more impact. Again, when we're mud stepping, we're practicing, learning how to root, how to find that instinctive space so you make contact with the other person's lower half of their body without needing to think about it. So even if there is a bit of a reach, right here, I'll step behind Mike's leg, reach up and through, and here, so here to actually step into him would be a little difficult. So what I would do is I would actually enter with my hand first and then come through. On the inside of the arm, so Mike punches the same hand, right? So here, again, you're like this, you block, you reach up. So now, a lot of people would say, well, you know, the punch is coming in, and you're not gonna be able to stop it like that. But the thing is, you're not blocking outward like this. You're not just trying to push the arm out. You're actually neutralizing it by spiraling the forearm, engaging the shoulder structure, and reaching up, and grinding your structure into his. And the big difference here is that when I step in, I immediately get his leg, right? Which then would land his face in my hand. And that's without using the second hand, right? So in Bagua, your hero got his foot again, right? So this second hand, so if he happened to come in and be smart and fast and have a second hand, second punch come in, and then you spiral, so you reach, so you use that momentum, even though that fist is traveling this way, when you come across and you sit on top, and you spiral on top, you can slam that forearm into the other person, and affect their structure, disrupt their center balance, and cause them to fall over, right? And that's, you know, that little balance is without me actually stepping through and closing. So doing this slowly, second punch comes in, right? And again, here we have the structure of green dragon, structure of claws, naturally catching that second arm, which is why we walk the circle in this way, why we practice this type of palm structure. So I could go down, right? Here's bare palm to neutralize on the inside. I anchor my forward arm. I step through, I begin to shift my weight through, step through and out, right? And into my structure. So depending on whether or not he actually stops up, whether or not he stops himself from falling, whether or not he's fast enough, right? And again, this is the same, you know, my instincts now are like, don't let him even get the hand out, right? So here, when you're stepping, so I'm not just, you know, pushing like this, right? What I'm actually doing is if I exaggerate this, right, I make contact, and so when I, so to exaggerate what I'm actually doing is I'm sitting, pushing, and grinding my forearm and spiraling it into a body check, into Spear in Heaven and Earth. And of course from here, so this might go back to where we were here, without him falling over, I can easily toe out, right? I can easily just go slam right through his face, then come back up with the green dragon stretch of claws, right? So whether or not you're on the outside or the inside of Spear in Heaven and Earth, so on the inside, right, you have this instinct and you're here and you have a modified, expanded version of, well, I could go and lie and play with the ball, right? Grab the arm, break the arm. But here you have a modified, expanded version of hide, flower, and leaf. And to basically explain, right, so with hide, flower, and leaf, I haven't finished the movement, so I would bump, right? And then I could come back over top. And again, because of the height difference, right, size difference, it mitigates and changes the way I'd actually apply on someone my own height, or someone smaller especially. Again, punching on the inside right here, entering, drilling, so you're drilling up, and that alone, right, that alone gives you that ability to step in and then close and bounce and shake through the other person's structure. So as you progress through the process of learning Spear in Heaven and Earth and applying Bhagavan methodology of rooting, shifting, sinking, expanding and spiraling and opening and closing the way the palm structures teach you. And again, once you get this with just the palm structures, the actual moving form, linking hands, becomes just icing on the cake, because it just expands your repertoire of possible movements exponentially to basically an infinite amount. So understanding, again here, you know, engage, blocking, this part right here is where I would anchor my elbow, and I do this fast, right, and throw him off balance, even if that punch, it's actually coming a little faster, right? You absorb and neutralize. So you absorb, this spiral is really, really important to understand, because you absorb, neutralize, and redirect all at the same time. All at the same time. So it's not like you have to go in, out, in. The spiral does it all at once. So Mike comes in right here, trapping his arm. Even if he gets a second punch, say he gets a second punch in, and I expand like this, well, guess what? This momentum, I've already neutralized this side, and this arm just came up. So I'm gonna step in and do Spear in Heaven and Earth this way, and I've just done an elbow strike to his heart. Now that doesn't stop him slamming my palm into the side of his face and breaking his knee as I come through. Working on understanding how to do even the basic palm structures inside and outside of a strike, being able to expand into and dropping through someone else's structure inside or outside of a strike is really, really important. And this is one of the beautiful things about Bhagavan, the palm structures, and the transitions. When you get the transitions, you understand that it does not matter whether or not you're on the outside or the inside of a punch or a kick. It will always work if you do the movement and have the structure. Thanks for watching.